That time on a Friday morning that we talk real estate, and Alison Waits joined us in the studio. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, obviously, with so many people around the Northern Rivers affected by the drastic floods that we've had in the last week or so, what sort of responsibilities do landlords and tenants have in regards to maintenance and also cleanup?
Yeah, hasn't it been devastating? Mm. So we've actually had several tenants in Ulmarra that have been flooded out. SES did remove them, which means you can get rent relief. So that's through landlord insurance and through your landlord as well. So you just want to make sure that you get communication right. Make sure you take photos. That's really a key important thing for tenants. Always take photos. Why the flood was happening after the flood, what's happened to the house and what's happened to your furniture and belongings. And especially if you're, say, in Ulmarra or McLean or Yamba, where we were flooded in, if it did go through the house or you were trapped out, so just on the land and not in the house, you can also seek rent relief, which means you just don't pay rent while it's inhabitable, because it is classed as inhabitable. If there's any issues with your landlord and your property manager, you do need to seek tribunal and NCAT for that order. Yeah.
All right. Now, you mentioned before about insurance. Now, is that landlord insurance? So the actual landlord has that insurance?
They should. Doesn't mean they have, but they should. They should have building insurance and also landlord insurance, which should cover rent relief and also any damages to the house. Also, for the tenants, they need to have contents insurance. Mm. So when we sign up tenants and all the other agency here, they do make sure that they do say that to the tenant, because their items are not covered by landlord insurance. Mm. And you can see by driving around town how much affected the property things are, like the cupboards, the mattresses, very expensive for tenants and for landlords too.
Yeah. So if the landlord doesn't have insurance, what do tenants do?
Oh, that's devastating, isn't it? So it makes it quite hard. So if they don't have insurance, the tenant will have to apply to tribunal if they're not getting any support by the owners, which makes it hard, because we're in a rental crisis right now. So where are they going to go?
Mm. Yeah, indeed. All right. And as far as landlords go, if their tenants, you know, can't pay the rent and they don't have any contents insurance, what happens there?
Very difficult, very difficult. So it does make it hard. I always suggest, if there's any urgent maintenance and the owners can't do it because they can't afford it or no insurance, tenants can spend up to $1,000 per item to get that fixed, like cleaning of the mould, damages to cupboards and floors and things like that. You can get up to $1,000. The owners have 14 days to reimburse. But anything over $1,000, you still can, but you have to apply to tribunal.
Yeah.
And if owners don't have the money, which some owners don't have any money at the moment as well, because we've had the COVID pandemic, they're going to have to apply for tribunal. Mm. It does make it very difficult. There are some wonderful landlords out there and property managers that are supporting. The government's also coming in with, you know, money as well, $1,000 per adult, $400 per child, which we have told our tenants about that as well.
All right, so the best thing to do is, if you're renting through a real estate agent, talk to your property manager.
Constantly keep in communication, take videos, take photos. Every day, send something through, because we need that for their insurance, for the owners, if there's insurance, obviously.
Mm. And if you're not renting through an actual real estate agent, still get to stay in contact with the actual owner.
Definitely, because the same rules apply, which we've talked about before on the morning show. Make sure that you do follow Residential Tenancy Act. It doesn't matter if it's private or with a real estate. Mm. The landlord still has to abide by the rules, which means they are in a set lease.
All right, thank you for your time this morning.
Awesome, thank you.
See you next week. Our house in the middle of